I've studied her career. I was trying to be like a really cool rock guy years ago. And no matter what, I still think she's the greatest female rock singer of all times. Karen Carpenter to me was like,
yeah.
You're talking about that angelic voice. Yeah, let me tell you a little history because I'm going to research some stuff. She would go into the studio, right? And they'd say, okay, we're going to record. And they knew the song. And they'd say, okay, let's get a test on the mic. And everybody would get a test, you know, because the tracks would be recorded. She'd come in. And the engineers would sit in the studio with their mouths open. And she'd finish it. She'd say, okay, I'm warmed up. I'm ready to go. And they were like, no, it's perfect. We got it. Because the engineer was smart enough to always hit record. And that's the tracks that you're hearing from Karen Carpenter. Wow. Was her warm-up. So isn't that like an amazing story? Yes. She was perfect. She was perfect. And then we went, so there's a lot of theories of, you know, why her eating disorder and all that other stuff. But we won't get into that. But just wanted to say, you know, you got to pay tribute to somebody who was considered so square at the time. But to me, you couldn't get cooler than Karen Carpenter, Richard Carpenter today. I just want to say that.
And
I'll shut up now.
How many of you guys know that she was actually a drummer? She was the original drummer of the band. And because she thought she couldn't sing. She thought she couldn't sing, and then they had her try out like on a demo. They were like, okay, you try singing it.
She was amazing. So I'm going to play this song for you. You know what's really funny? We play it everywhere we go.